I'm Professor Vladislav Ognjanov, Senior Professor in Genetics and Fruit Breeding, founder and breeder of MAVM Nursery from Novi Sad, Serbia. IPM Horticulture Fair was ideal opportunity to present production and breeding achievements of MAVM Nursery to International Horticulture Society. For the introduction, just to say that our nursery has two different lines of young tree fruit tree production. One line is for large commercial fruit production for large orchards, and another line is for hobby gardeners, for amateur orchards, which is now more and more important part of our production. These two lines actually always had a nursery strategy, which means fruit breeding and innovation programs, where hip factor was always strategy. Fruit breeding and innovation was a strategy of nursery for recognition and competitiveness and contribution to sustainable development of fruit growing. To achieve that, we actually are developing several areas of fruit breeding, meaning genetic resources, genetic and fruit breeding. That's on one side hybridization, and you will see on another side mutation, and innovation and fruit production, fruit production always towards organic farming, and innovation and plant propagation methodologies and procedures, very essential, because we propagate and have, I would say, some kind of breeding activities in over 100 different fruit species. Our nursery deals exclusively just fruit species. Genetic diversity in our nursery comes mainly from collaboration with fruit breeders, institutes and faculties, then very important from farmers, fruit enthusiasts, from collectors, private gene banks, environmentalists. This collaboration, the most valuable asset of that collaboration is an inexhaustible source of ideas and initial breeding material in our collection, in our work. So far, three European trips also were organized to extend the collaboration with nurseries and the amateur collectors of specific fruit crops. In our nursery, we have extensive private fruit breeding program in palm, stone, nut, and woody fruit species, but also large collections of subtropical fruits, citrus fruits, exotic fruits, and on the ornamental fruit species. From this IPM fair, you know, I thought that we have a very large citrus collection. When I see what is in the hall, you know, I'm really disappointing, and I won't say it anymore. We here are listed and in the brochure about 97, but there are more than 97 different fruit species that we work with. And in all these species, these species are represented with our own release varieties, leading varieties serving as a standards varieties, and selections serving as a potential parents of hybridization, autochthonous varieties, genotypes from on-farm selection, interspecific hybrid, and seedling population as a result of hybridization. As you saw in the film, all spread on 3.5 hectares. For that, we have human resources to manage the nursery. Aleksandar Radin, present here, is a nursery manager. In her shadow over our nurseries for over 20 years. Then Aleksandar Ognjanov, dealing with genetic resources and the IT coordinator, and Marina Ognjanov, sales manager and landscape architect. Apple breeding. First selection goal that we had is breeding commercial varieties, high fruit quality, and always disease resistance. And that disease resistant is actually a durable disease resistant, which actually stays on pyramiding the vertical and polygenic horizontal resistant gene. These polygenic horizontal resistant genes always come from our local autochthonous varieties. In 2018, we released two varieties, Ivana and Iskra, completely resistant to mildew and scab, and the latest one, Aleksandra, released in 2022. Ivana 7 days before Gala ripens, Iskra 7 days later, and Aleksandra is a yellow variety, very late ripening somewhere in November. Very good quality, very good taste, and good storability. Ivana, this is the state release trial for apple varieties. Standard was Ideret. We see Ideret trees and Ivana in the same conditions. Also in the second year, very fruitful. Fruits are sometimes even 700 grams. These two fruits are Granny Smith and in the Golden Delicious, 9 centimeters in diameter. Excellent overcolor of Ivana. Iskra, the most resistant that I ever saw, actually. Apple virtually can be grown without any chemical treatments. Aleksandra, I said, the newest one, and many other selections. So far, we organized two tasting panels for students, for growers, for public. And also, here are some of the selections, what we found in our cold store. A lot of advanced selections, some of them can be seen in the field trial, like this hybrid. The hybrid, this is a Granny Smith type, very excellent, clean fruits, acid taste, but fruits are a little bit elongated. Again, we are looking for a good late maturing varieties of red color, because we think with green and yellow that we sorted somehow the problem of late maturing apples. Also, we breed for early maturing varieties, because cold store are more or less empty the end of June, and then we actually come with early maturing varieties as a fresh apple from the tree. Very important for amateur growers, and the best selections were coming from on-farm selections of local variety Petrovača. Petrovača, as you see, excellent fruit finish and very good taste, completely resistant variety, and also Petrovača, but the green-yellow fruits. Our varieties in apples are part of many organic stories. The most successful is Dolovac organic, where our apples are not sold as organic, but also is a material to produce fruit energy bars, and so successful fruit product that USAID actually financed that product to be part of as an exclusive product to them drugstores. Mutation breeding. Mutation breeding also is very, very important part of our breeding work. For 15 years, we educated fruit growers to spot the mutants and to actually work with us until we don't actually test them on large-scale production and actually named them. The first and the most selection you can see is Ideret. This is standard Ideret and this is the mutation. Here are the fruit standard Ideret and the mutation of Ideret. As you see, this is the color 7 days before normal ripening time of Ideret. How it looks on the large scale in the orchard. We released even, that was Gordana, named Gordana. Jerina and Semendria also red mutation of Fionago red and red mutation of Elstar. This is the most, the nicest apple that I ever saw is a mutant of Elstar. And the latest mutation that we located is Topaz. Last year we had a very poor fruit of apples, but we found some. This is a standard Topaz, was very warm, and these are the two mutants that were selected from variety Topaz. Also, Columna tree habit was a selection goal in our breeding program for nearly 20 years. 15 years ago, we released 6 varieties, and first varieties were quite tall. They were over 2 meters. And then Mr. Tuan was always demanding and said, you know, now they are very vigorous, although they said that they weren't vigorous once. And then we had to diminish them under the 2 meters. And we actually succeeded this with the Smaragd, one yellow one, NS11-111. And the latest variety that was released last year was really something, I think that's something what really we even hardly expected. Completely resistant columnar apples up to 180 meters. Very large fruit, excellent fruit shape, excellent taste, and excellent fruit finish. You see the size of the apples. But I stress again, disease resistant is remarkable. And then again was demand for dwarf trees, and we have 2 of them, one green and one red. We hope to be release them next year. Now the trial is in the final stage. Mia never grows more than this. It is very good as a potted tree. Also Sophia, also although Sophia is a bit more vigorous, and now as a grown tree, 12 years old, it is about a meter, about 1.2 meter after 12 years. One of our selection goals were spreading our columnar habit, but red flesh apples. Last year we had the first crop, and as you see there are some results. Also we have one columnar with red flesh and columnar. Also apples, some were grafted as a baby apples for your trial. Selection goal in pairs again, disease resistant, always disease resistant on the top top priority. Fungal diseases, Psila pyricola and Erwinia amylovora resistant. But the flesh quality has to be European pear, melting and juicy. These selection goals, first we look at European pears, autochthonous varieties. Hundreds and hundreds, thousands of trees in backyards you can find in Serbian villages, old from 100 to more, maybe even more years. Karamanka is the world famous, and there are also other, some with flesh. Now we are working on Lubeničarka to find the most colored, red colored flesh. Then some pears for drying, for making jam. And this was actually all in Pyrus pyrifolia. In our collection, we realized that the naši pears, but do not need any spraying. And but the quality, our people do not like naši pears very much because the flesh is very crispy. That's why we crossed with William's pear, and result of this cross was Ivanino Zlato, released in 2018 with the flesh of Pyrus communis, completely resistant to diseases. Again, state trial. This is Ivanino Zlato, and this is the William's pear in unsprayed condition. Fruits are about 400 grams or 300, 400 grams. Very nice skin finish and completely resistant. You don't need any spraying on Ivanino Zlato. Another trial was actually, I was surprised with the beauty of Ya pears. It is a Chinese white pear. In our supermarkets, we don't have the mother trees. Even I made contact with several Chinese breeders, but they don't know for the, and I don't know where these fruits are coming from China, but who knows where. We bought several kilos of these fruits. We extracted the seeds. It is the seedling population. And you see, here are two. One here and one here. This hybrid ripens the beginning of August, another one the beginning of September. Very attractive, and really overcomes any Chinese or Japanese variety in our collection. And we have really quite a few directly obtained from China and from Japan. Again, completely resistant. You see September, this was September, still trees, fruits on the tree from this selection. And it was on the tree for maybe two, three weeks and edible trees. They stay on the trees edible for quite a long time. Another challenge, but really very serious challenge, was columnar pear tree habit. And selection strategy was first to look for the varieties with pyramid narrow upright tree habit. And we collected many different varieties and first look at the Pyrus communis. This is Hardy Gellert. And with a little bit of pruning, it can be quite a nice columnar pear. Also, naši pears, this is variety Shinseiki, with pruning, you can make a very virtually ideal columnar pear, but of course with some pruning. Another step was to utilize on-farm selections and few genotypes from private collections, and we got quite a few interesting selections for, let's say, dwarf or semi-dwarf to proper columnar one. These are ours, and this is Decora. Also, here you can see our varieties, very straight, very nice distribution of flower spurs along the upright cordon. Here is the quality of fruits, very tasty, late but very tasty, fruits. And then what we actually, the miracle of our breeding program is this variety or selection. It is completely resistant to diseases. Nothing, no psila, no aphids, no fungal diseases. You see, distribution of fruit is very, very, very fruitful one. And it is interesting as a columnar tree, but when we use it as a parent, we got a very large number of seedlings, and this year they will be planted. First, what we realized that also seedlings were completely resistant for 2 years, completely resistant to any diseases, and the size was on, let's say, dwarf ones to here we can see a proper columnar, but columnar even when they are 1 year old. You see, every bud develop the spurs 10 centimeters. Next year there will be, we hopefully, there will be flower buds and and to obtain very nice, I don't know for the fruit quality because they didn't fruit, but the foliage, the architecture of the leaves, this really hybrid combination is unique, and we expect quite a lot of them to reach the quality of plants, not of fruit. Fruit, of course, has to be edible and good, but to have quality of plants of columnar apples, that we have a proper columnar pear.
Queens. Sidonia oblonga.
We test many on-farm selections. We insist, of course, most important, tolerance to Erwinia albilovora, but also bright yellow fruit, no hair, and intense aroma of Leskovačka queens. Leskovačka queens is very good quality and good fragrance, good aroma, but very sensitive to fire blight. This is the most successful our selection. And what is special here, not only aroma and the quality, but the size, and the fruits last for at least twice the Leskovačka or other on the shelf without any cooling. Mespilus, also medlar, is very, not very important, but more and more important now for even large-scale production in Serbia. The selection goal was tolerance to Erwinia milovora, and what we achieved is turns brown and softened without need of exposure to frost. Usually, medlar fruit has to be exposed to the severe frost to soften, but our, it doesn't need. And for example, in a year like this, when we had during the autumn summer, we had ripened fruits in November from our selection. Peach breeding also is elaborate, and I will go quickly through it. First, mutation breeding, Ivana released in 2017 from the peach large-scale production of Ivana and Spring Lady. Spring Lady is the best European early maturing variety. Ivana proved to be a much, much better variety because it's virtually like nectarine, extremely low pubescence. This is when it was found as a mutant. This it is mutation of spring crest. How it looks in the middle of the crown. Ivana doesn't need summer pruning to get a nice over color. Fruit attractiveness is really unique, and I think that very, very successful early maturing variety for commercial orchards. For amateur orchards, we produced two varieties. It is a vineyard peach type, large fruited with vineyard peach taste, which means unique aroma and fragrance of the flesh. Marsha, it's the end of July, July, very well colored, 300 grams, very, very attractive and excellent eating quality. And Marsha is lead colors, but it's 15 days later. 15 days later with really attractive fruit. You see 635 grams to fruit, excellent quality. And one another selection goal always was when we have a breeding program in apples, in pears for columnar, we tried to work with columnar peach and the nectarine foam. From Kernelsville, from West Virginia, I got one genotype of pillar peaches and nectarines. And in the first few years, they were brilliant columnar peaches. We could plant it, them a meter apart, one or from another. But after 5, 6, 7 years, they get very, very tall, and they are not appropriate for hobby gardeners. That's why we tried to actually diminish the vigorness. We selfed these two genotypes. We produce 1,000 seedlings, and actually looked for vigor reduction. And also we think that with the dwarf rootstocks, with scion rootstock interaction, we can even lower a little bit of vigor of this of our hybrids. These are the seedlings from the glass house. And actually selection gain. What was the selection gain? Here we you see the first harvest of seedlings. Very nice, healthy, dark green foliage. They were, as a plant, they were much nicer than these two genotypes obtained from United States. They are all single trunk tree with reduced branching number and growth. You see here, reduce here, compared to a vigorous, also there were vigorous seedlings. These are these from United States, and our, which is less than half of the mother. And the miracle was that we obtained even a few, four seedlings, dwarf seedlings. And one of them, it is really very attractive, and maybe I'm wrong, but it is the first dwarf nectarine hybrid, with orange fruit color. All our peaches or nectarines, they are red color. And then red flesh nectarines. Again, hundreds of hybrids. We use our own germplasm to create, and this is the result. And the result, you know that Alexandra and Alexander probably were poisoned by peaches to taste all of them. But result of their work are completely red flesh nectarines, excellent taste. Italian selections, because I think that there is no varieties. Italian selections, they use Chinese germplasm, and everything is more or less as you see on this slide. By the acidity, the fruit taste is extremely acid. Ours are excellent taste, and we hope even that we will obtain even better taste using now our varieties and White Glory as a variety. You see, it has a very, I would say, it nice red, faint red color, and when it's completely ripe, this beautiful fresh flesh. And the hybrid between those two probably will give something even better diversity. But all this now I'll multiply for the second stage of selection. We look for disease resistance problem with our growers. We always have to stress, please spray for Tafrina, spray for Tafrina. We are specialized nursery for peach varieties, and we make them actually to pick the peaches and nectarines 4 months from our variety list. But the problem is Tafrina, because very few people are spraying. Now we have a very reliable germplasm to start resistance to Tafrina deformance, genes coming from Funus davidiana, then Chiara, Italian variety. And also we are looking, we don't have in our collection, Ali Blanca, which is the progeny of one local Italian variety, Cesarini, and it's a polygenic resistant, giving actually hypersensitivity, not the resistance, but hypersensitivity of, but it will be good to combine with previous two varieties. Apricot, we look for resistant to abiotic stress, and you see, for 6 years we don't harvest apricots in Serbia. Thanks to the late spring frost, the latest 2 years ago was on 28th of April. But some trees, you see, give the fruit. Also, this is one of our selections. You see the flowering potential. And what is very important, resistant to biotic stress. They give very nice fruits. You saw no cospirosporium, no these spots on the tree, and no damage to Monilia laxa. Otherwise, if late spring frost doesn't take off the tree flowers, Monilinia does it. But that's why we actually select also for Clusterosporium and Monilinia resistant. Another selection goal was we were following the ideas of these French breeding programs where they produce September apricots. We use again our own germplasm, Hindu Kush apricot selection, and actually in Serbia, commercial varieties ripen from early June to mid-July. And we would like MAVM selection to cover from mid-July to mid-September, another two months. And this is the first result. This is the end of July. Very attractive, nice, shiny, you know, quite a few very successful selections. Then this is the August, covers the August, even some extremely well-colored for August hybrids. And this is from September, 5th of September, when these three selections were picked, but the fruits are unripe. But it is just the first pick from the hybrids last years. In plum, we released one extra large fruited, very disease resistant and probably Monilia resistant one called Marina, with fruits up to even over 100 grams, the same ripening season as a top taste. And but a small problem with this variety, that it's self-sterile. And now we have another selection, the same ripening season. Fruits are about 80 grams. Every year they fruit, although if this spring frost occur, and very promising, actually brought from on-farm selection of one farmer from Cerevic. Large fruiting selections of Prunus spinosa, but a little bit disappointing thing is that good quality, but disease resistant is not adequate for amateur growers. Sweet cherry, we have two dwarf compact tree forms here and here are the trees. These are the normal varieties, normal varieties. Again, the young trees and the normal cherry tree from our nursery. And only a bit of problem is that they ripen at the same time. Fruit quality is excellent. In sour cherry, we actually tried to produce also mini compact dwarf tree habit. The idea came, I like this slide very, very much, because this is the sour cherry tree and this is the red currant. Completely the same size. We analyzed pomologically what means this small tree, and we saw some traits that are essential. First of all, that variety selection produces flower buds on every on 1 year old shoot. Every 1 year old shoot has flower buds, no vegetative buds. Then what is very important is because they are some kind of Morello type and they don't branch much, but we selected tree selection that have incredible, here you see, incredible good side branches, although they have flower buds on 1 year old shoots. and another two. You can see these trees are over 12 years old. I don't know how old they are when we planted them. When you actually utilize the rootstock scion interaction with our varieties, you can get trees like this only with pruning. With pruning, you can cut the 1 year old branches and to obtain the columnar tree habit. If you don't do it, you get a very nice small crown, but on low vigorous rootstocks. If you use Gisela 5, you have the trees. Here you can see the fruit potential of this selection. Incredible fruit potential, good quality, and they can be planted maybe on half a meter apart. Now we are trying to establish our rootstock breeding program. These are from interspecific hybridization Prunus serrazus with Prunus mahaleb. And what was very surprising is that these hybrids are resistant to root borer, which is very, very severe problem in Serbia now in cherry production. Completely dry trees, and our is green, and it roots very well. You see roots even above the ground. Sour cherry, also Morello type, we try to improve the yield. And we have a very good, in our collection, we have many varieties, local varieties grow in Serbia because they are very, very popular in every yard in village. You have Morello type. And the best selection field was village Feketic and Mali Iđoš. Hungarian villages with Hungarian people living there. 20,000 approximately trees propagated from suckers, all chance seedlings of Feketićka sour cherry. And you see, we actually, I didn't have that much experience with cherry breeding, and it was joint breeding activity with Professor Janos Apostol from Budapest, who helped quite a lot with Feketićka sour cherry and selection. And we selected many different types, including picota type that I saw in Spain, that you can pick in the fruits without actually bleeding on the top. And Feketićka sour cherry, it is something remarkable when cherry varieties or local varieties are. Why? Because completely tolerant and resistant to Blumeriella japica, Cerosporium, Monilinia, Laxa. But even furthermore, it is actually important biochemical composition. And biochemical composition means that anthocyan content of Feketićka sour cherry is 10 times higher than the best Hungarian variety Erdibotermo. And this is the wine. If you come and visit Serbia in our nursery, you will taste the wine from Feketićka sour cherry, probably the best thing that I ever actually drank in my life. Something specific, very limited production, but in a traditional way. And you see many different products from Feketićka sour cherry in that village. And now quickly I will go. We have a large almond production. and we are trying to select resistant varieties, low blooming varieties, and to find which variety is overlapping with flowering days. Because what we realize, we now do this for 2 years, we realize that almond is much frost and late spring frost hardy than apricot. And actually in Serbia, it grows normally in the lowland, in Kac, which is plain, it's Pannonian plain. And the same results we got when we have the parallel trial on 300 meters in Fruška Gora. And now we are selecting within these 24 varieties that we, and now we have a very reliable assortment for really commercial production of almond in Serbia. Again, you see the test. Walnuts, important tolerance to walnut anthracnosis. We pick the on-farm selections that they are middle flowering, not early, because the mid-flowering one, they escape the primary infection of Pneumonia juglandis, and the secondary infections are not so strong, and you actually pick very, very good quality quality fruits. The newest selection is sour. And this is also very interesting, you know, these large fruited ones. This is 7 centimeters long fruit selections with very, a lot of effort we actually paid to woody species. I won't read, I will just go quickly through it. Mulberry, we have our own mulberry selections. Up to 16 grams are the fruits with white, pink and black color in two tastes, sweet and sweet-sour taste. Again, rose hips. These are when you use for on a large scale production, you use the rootstocks. They are laxa. Laxa, even the, this machine for harvesting was was bought, but we have two our selection. First, they are thornless, very good for amateur growers, because you pick the hips very easily. Quality is very, hips are very large and they ripen very uniform. Sorbus domestica, it is very, very traditional fruit species in Serbia. Every tree in Serbia of sorbus is about 200 years old. And now we are trying to select for best genotypes and to find the proper way of multiplication to lower the vigor of, and it is possible, but maybe later if someone is, I can explain. Selection of elderberry, Sambucus nigra, the main variety in Serbia, because in north part of Serbia people grow quite a lot elderberries, but they use Austrian variety Hasberg. Hasberg is in Serbia about 100 grams. Our selection is 356. It's a bunch three times the size of Hasberg, and not only the fruit, but you can see the flower. Flower is about 50-60 centimeters in diameter, and very fragrant. You can make very good juice syrup out of our selections. Cornus massa, cornelian cherry, we probably have one of the best selections in Europe with fruits that are usually the first were about 8-9 grams. Now they are over 12 grams large, pear shape or round shape of these are plants that you don't need to spray at all, completely all woody species. The citrus fruits, you know, Ivana, the lady who is third generation of breeders in our nursery, giving the contribution. Then we are looking for Actinidia chilensis for kiwi, but self-pollinated. From time to time, it appears people are coming and said, "Yeah, we have just one plant, no kiwis around for 1 kilometer, and they fruit enormously." And we don't know where the pollen comes, if it comes. And now we will start to do the anatomy of these flowers and to see actually if they are really self-compatible or self-pollinated. Fruit quality is excellent, like in commercial varieties. Actinidia are good at just collection. They Chinese date, of course, we don't have the breeding program, but I heard 30, 40 years ago from China, thornless, also here, I pay attention, there is no thornless variety of Ziziphus jujuba. But 40 years ago, China, as a state gift to Yugoslavia at that time, gave one thornless large fruited Ziziphus jujuba. We located this tree in Macedonia, and now we vegetatively propagated it. We introduced pistachio and are testing to see if they can grow in our continental climates. Diospyros khaki, also we are looking for this khaki cross with Virginiana to find resistant to low temperature, because this lot of varieties, they have excellent quality. They are not the size of Diospyros khaki or Tipo, only size, but the quality of the fruit is better. Also, you see black khaki. Then pomegranate, the selection we are doing on farm. We have two selections of pomegranate that are fruiting near Novi Sad on two locations for 15 years. They give the commercial size of the fruit, and fruit every year hundreds of fruits. Now we multiply them. Hopefully it has the frost resistance. The cat, she's also, he's always the, also the member. Yes. I think that it's finished. Fig, olives, and some exotic fruit also we do, and that's all. You know, the gumi and so on. But, and that's all. And maybe just, Peter, for the conclusion, it is not all. You all have invitation to come to Serbia, to our nursery, to see actually that it's not all and that we have even more than this, and you are welcome anytime. Thank you very much.